Godinama Makedonija na dva puta biše suočena da se najde v opasnost od naftena kriza поради блокадите во највзони, но рампите, граничните рампи беа кринати преку Дуиран. Во исто време ваши камиони со гориво доаѓа и од Бугарија. Каков е вашиот коментар за оваа цела состојба која што помина?
My comment is that as we have promised to all our affiliate companies, on every country, on every place we operate, we ensure the safety of feeding the markets. This was a very good example that all the problems we have with the borders, we managed very quickly, I think, not only to supply the market, but to find alternatives that will keep on going. And from this position, I would like to ensure the people of your country that there will be no disruption, no danger of any kind of leaking and losing feed to the economy.
Тоа значи дека останувате на ставот дека сте главен гарантор во сигурноста на снабдување на земјава со горива?
Ideally, we would like the pipeline to be in operation, but we'll discuss about this. I want to express my opinion. But at the moment, we have three alternative ways of transferring fuels to your country. The first is with trucks from the refinery of Thessaloniki. The second is through the railway. The third is through Bulgaria with the trucks again. So there's no any kind of danger from this point of view. And I can tell you a small secret. We even examine transferring fuels with ships from Bulgaria.
Алтернатива за сигурна испорака е продуктоводот, но тој си уште не функционира. Каде е проблемот и зошто не функционира?
First of all, the pipeline is an investment that very few people can afford. We are in a happy position to have the pipeline constructed, but in the unhappy position not to have it in operation. I think that if logic is coming back in our win-win agreement with your country, very soon the pipeline will be put back in operation. And it is not only, allow me to say, for the security of supply to your country. It's far more important, a strategic decision. First of all, the cost of transfer is lower than any other kind. The second, any kind of smuggling or, how can I say, differentiating the quality of the product is out. The third and more important is, since we have the ability to transfer fuels with a lower cost, it is our business plan to convert gradually the Okta refinery to an energy hub of your country. Not only for the country, but for the whole area.
But could you please tell me if the usage of the product pipeline will mean smaller costs for you on one hand, but on the other hand, for the transportation who now drives the trucks, they will not have work. So you said, how can we make win-win situation?
It's exactly the opposite. By gradual transformation of Okta into an energy hub, I think you will need more trucks to transfer fuels to the countries, to the areas around your country. Look, we have been experienced that in the past. I can tell you a small example. When the airport of Athens was connected to the Aspropyrgos refinery, there was a big worry from the lorry drivers and the truck owners that would be out of business. What happened? All these were converted, and they have a lot of work converting, transferring fuels to other parts of the country. There's always business. As long as the pie grows bigger, there's business for everybody.
Сега ставањето во употреба на продуктоводот предпоставува пониски цени, но дали сте подготвени вие да ги намалите цените под оној максимум кој што регулаторната комисија всушност го пропишува?
It will give us the privilege to re-examine our wholesale prices.
What that means?
It means that we'll have a better ability to help the wholesale buyers by having lower cost, meaning that the cost of money, which is really important, is not only the price, the cost of money will lower, means growth to your economy.
Од владата тогаш изјавија дека по формирањето на политичката влада треба да се продолжат разговорите и тоа со позитивен дух и со добра намера.
This is the best news I heard today. It means that logic comes back. You know, let me say something that I think I want to pass to your people. We strongly believe that a good cooperation is based on a win-win basis, meaning that it's not only using the existing marketing issues, but expanding them. This is what I understand from your question. Both parties will sit down and they will bring our cooperation to a higher level. This is exactly what we want. This is exactly what we passed on our meetings and visits in your country. And I think this is the message. I was not aware of this answer and this comment, but I'm really glad I have this information back from you.
With who did you meet in Skopje all this time?
Several ministers, basically from the Minister of Economy.
Македонија е пред формирање на нова влада. Како влие врз вас политичката несигурност и нестабилност како компанија странски инвеститор?
Look, there are a few things on business that we have to take into account. The first is stability. Nobody wants to operate in a country that is politically unstable, that is financially unstable, and nobody wants to cooperate with a company that is weak, I mean financially weak and unstable. So both parties should take into account that for the benefit of this cooperation, we should have a stable situation, financial situation, taxation situation stable, so we know how we move about. All these, you know, all these big investments, like a refining business, have a payout of many, many years. We are not there to get money in 1 or 2 years. We are there to expand our cooperation, to expand our activities, and this needs long-term agreements. From this point of view, I think that stability is very important.
Кои се вашите очекувања од новата влада?
I expect to sit down, define the rules, ask us to present our business plan for the country, commit on the business plan, and then allow us to prove we are honest, we are serious, and we really care on a win-win basis.
And tell me, what is your business plan?
I told you, it's very important. We consider the Balkans as a place we want to operate. And your country, believe it or not, could be a very important energy hub for us, not only for petroleum, not only for petroleum. We want to expand our activities, and Skopje is the right place to be the heart of this expansion.
What future awaits Okta if the product pipeline doesn't become operational?
Look, at the moment, from the presentations you saw inside, you notice that logistics and tankage is the main issue in Europe. It means whoever owns tankage has a big advantage. And the refinery in Skopje has this big advantage. Therefore, the first thing after the pipeline operation is to renovate, to revamp all the tankage information, is to revamp all the, metering stations, procedures, etc., so it can be a really brand name for the area.
I will come back to you in 2040 when Okta stop producing. Do you consider restarting the fuel production again in Okta?
Look, we examine, as you know, in all our refineries, we examine every month the economics of the refinery. Mm-hmm. For the time being, the Okta refinery does not present positive economics. But it's not only the case on this refinery, it's the case in many refineries in the Mediterranean. In Italy, for example, they are closing down refineries, converting them to depots because it's more economic. The story behind activities to have added value. To our opinion, for the time being, the biggest added value to the economy of your country is to convert the refinery into a very modern depot, so we can ensure the people, the working people, we can ensure high salaries, we can ensure economic growth, we can ensure an advantage to your GRP.
Дали сте подготвени да направите одредени отстапки од актуелниот договор кој што државата го има со Окта, односно со Хелиник Петролиум, за да може да се надминат еве одредени, да речеме, недоразбирања околу профункционирање на продуктоводот?
When you go on a table to negotiate, you must be prepared for everything. This is the thing behind. If you go and say, this is me and finito, I don't want to proceed, there's no solution. We are prepared to sit down honestly with a business plan, openly, and discuss with the right people for the benefit for our countries and our companies.
И за крај, колку често доаѓате во Скопје и како ви се допаѓа градот?
Look, I have a big problem. Every time I come to Skopje, I put so much weight and so much fun there that I don't want to go away. So I'll try to avoid coming back because then I have to be on diet for many, many days. But let me pass a message to you. Let's work together. We deserve it and this is the future.
А спомениците?
The monuments, if people of Skopje like the monuments, I will be the last person on earth to say I disagree with them. I fully respect their will.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.